Greetings YouTube, this is yet another Dave with yet another video on music related gear. Here's my Revox A77 open reel recorder. I got off eBay, it sounds great, but I have to push the treble on the EQ to get a nice clear sound. And so, of course, I need to clean and demagnetise the heads and the entire tape track. I want to thank 12 Volt Vids for their great video, which saved me spending $100 on a demagnetiser. And I realised that actually they're just a alternating electromagnet running off an AC current. And I thought I might be able to add a couple of things of my own. For example, alcohol wipes, which you get at your local pharmacy, quite good for cleaning the heads. And an easy way without going off to buy bottles of isopropyl. Second question is, how do you know if your heads need demagnetising? There's a lot of debate over whether it's necessary or not. Well, simple test. If you get a light gauge guitar string, an E about 10 or lighter, and just dangle it around the works here, you can see it's getting quite clearly attracted to all the metal parts, in particular the erase head here. And the main problem with this recorder is I notice that if I try and record over old tapes, the old recording is there faintly in the background, so the erase head wasn't working properly. So as you can see very clearly, these parts have become magnetized over the years by having magnetic tape dragged over them. And time to make myself a demagnetizer. 12 Volt Vid suggested wrapping a coil wire that he gotten out of an old electric motor around a lump of iron. Occurred to me that a more likely thing that guitar builders and players is going to have lying around is an old pickup. Pull the magnet off the back. Don't get that anywhere near things. And you got yourself a coil ready to go. If you find yourself an AC power adapter and hook it up, you'll create an alternating field magnet, which you can use to effectively scrub the permanent magnetism that's built up on these iron pieces. And here's a better close-up showing the guitar string clearly being affected by a magnetic field around these parts. If you don't have a guitar string handy, you can also just use a bit of magnetic tape. Just a scrap of tape, and you see it being influenced by a magnetic field around here. Both attracted and repelled, because of course the tape itself does have some magnetic recording on it. Okay, so once you got yourself an AC power adapter to go from your main supply to a low voltage AC current, and you've connected it up to your old guitar pickup with the magnet taken off the back, you can figure out if it's a safe setup by the use of Ohm's law, voltage equals current times resistance, which means that the current is the voltage divided by the resistance. In this case, it's a 9 volt output, and the resistance of this pickup is around 5,000 ohms, actually 5.38K. So dividing 9 volts by 5,380 ohms, you get a current of about 1.5 milliamps. So this is rated up to 1 amp, so no problems there. So long as your current doesn't exceed the rating on the power adapter, you won't blow your coils. So I'm going to plug this in and we can test if it's generating an alternating magnetic current by holding it close to a guitar pickup that's plugged in, and we should hear a 50 or 60 hertz hum through the pickup depending where you are in the world. Fingers crossed. Okay, so good so far. And now let's see if we're generating that magnetic field. And there it is, no doubt about it. It's generating that alternating magnetic field, and it's such a high resistance in this coil, it's not overheating. Alright, now we've got the guitar pickup hooked up to the AC current, 9 volts. And so we've got our alternating electromagnet. And if we just bring it down slowly and gradually swipe across the magnetized metal pieces, think of it as a scrubbing action. That little magnetic brush going backwards and forwards 50 times a second here in Australia, and I can feel the magnetic field like a sort of a terrain of pressure up and down against the electromagnet, which seem to indicate it's doing its job. It's not getting hot. There's no smoke coming out of the wall wart. So it looks like the experiment might be working. I can definitely feel that field around the erase head. I'm not touching anything, but I'm getting closer with each sweep. Yeah, I can really feel the repulsion on those heads. But as I go over it slowly, the repulsion lessens, then is gone completely. Jiggling all those tiny little magnetic dipoles around, down in these steel parts, and re-scattering them in random directions so that overall they don't have a magnetic field. Quite strong there. And so don't interfere with the reading of the very small magnetic field on the magnetic tape. I was reading, can't remember if it was in 12 volt vids or comments somewhere, saying what you expect with magnetized heads is a drop off in the treble frequencies. And as I said, I've been having to set my EQ with anything up to plus 10 decibels in the upper registers to get a nice, flat, crisp sound out of this recorder. So between the amount of dirt that these pads wiped off the heads and this field that I can feel myself flattening out as I go slowly across, hopefully that top end response should come back up. I can hardly feel any magnetic attraction or repulsion now as I slowly scrub across. And yep, that's done. And I could feel the difference it made. Now to hear it. So as I said, I've had to be pushing the top end of the EQ very hard to get a nice crisp sound off the tape. I'm all loaded up, ready to go. Let's have a listen to the new clean heads. Wow, okay, so I do not need all this treble boost now. Maybe still a bit. No doubt about it, right across the frequency spectrum, things are so much clearer, like washing the windscreen of a car. Here's how it sounds direct into the camera, out of the headphones, out of the Revox. Best of all, I just pressed record over a section of tape I didn't want, playing it back. Sweet silence, not a single trace of the previous recording.